So we have a trans Olympic athlete that stated that if they were to win a medal during the Olympics, they would burn the American flag on the medal podium. You're supposed to be representing the United States, but if you win, you're going to burn the American flag. So that athlete by the name of Chelsea Wolf stated this in a since-deleted Facebook post back in March of 2020, and also mentioned the mistreatment of trans children rather than focusing on the pandemic. So at the time, Chelsea Wolf was criticizing Trump, focusing on trans children and not on the pandemic, which I believe he handled the pandemic better, much better than a Joseph Biden Jr. would have handled the pandemic, much better. By his own admission, it was xenophobic to restrict travel from China in the midst of the pandemic, and we already know where the origin was. So aside from that, we have to focus on these leftists in society today who are so openly anti-American, anti-America. Their hatred for America is just blatant. And it's odd when I see this because a lot of these leftists, they've never even been within a 100-mile radius of their own birthplace. I'm not kidding you. I'm from California. I know people who are far on the left. I have people who are far on the left in my own family, relatives. I noticed that they're actually not very knowledgeable about other countries around the world. And they are not knowledgeable about how much freedom they have in comparison to American citizens. Because in America, even today, we are still the most freest country in the world for its citizens. Our Constitution is the only constitution on the planet that empowers its citizens to the degree that it actually does. Only country in the world. Just because society is speaking out against trans athletes playing on the same teams as biological girls, biological women, just because people have a problem with that, that doesn't make them oppressive towards trans people. Men and women are separated in sports. Does that mean that men are oppressing women because we've separated them in sports? No, it's because of the biological differences between the two. One has a natural unfair advantage. This is well documented. I don't know what biology books you guys have, but standard biology books that I read, standard human physiology books, they made it very clear that there are biological differences between the human male and the human female. So there's no oppression going on here when it comes to this issue. But according to Chelsea Wolf, this is why Chelsea Wolf was upset and wanted at the time, hopefully still doesn't want to do that, because that's crazy, to represent America in the Olympics and burn the flag on the podium all over the whole trans athlete discussion, all over that. It doesn't make any sense, and it's just people on the far left like Chelsea Wolf embracing an oppression narrative that is simply not true, because no one is oppressing you because they're not allowing you to be on a sports team where you have an obvious advantage over everyone else. That is not someone oppressing you, in my opinion. And that is not transphobia or whatever phobia, but I know how people on the far left, you like to demonize people. You like to shut down a conversation when people have a difference of opinion. Me having a difference of opinion really upsets leftists. It makes them mad because I have to think the way that they want me to think. I can't be a free thinking man, which is actually very, very totalitarian, which is ironic because this individual, Chelsea Wolf, spoke out against fascism. It's trying to speak out against totalitarianism. But we know that a lot of leftists, you guys don't mind totalitarianism as long as it is in what you believe to be your favor. And I'm not saying that you have to be the most patriotic person. If you're just an American citizen, you don't have to be that. But if you are an Olympic US athlete, you represent your country. That's how the Olympics works. So it's crazy as hell that you want to represent the country and then burn the flag of the country that you represent. That's crazy as hell. And it's crazy that you think that you're so oppressed in a country where many of the citizens are spoiled. Let's be honest, many American citizens are spoiled, especially the ones that talk about how they are constantly being oppressed. Many people that push oppression narratives are, in all honesty, spoiled people. They don't even realize how spoiled they are in comparison to people worldwide. This is why people still flood to our country at a ridiculous rate, despite all of the bad PR that America gets from leftists. Despite how terrible leftists say America is, there's still people from third world, second world, and even first world countries that still flood to America. I wonder why. US trans Olympic athlete stated that my goal is to win the Olympics so I can burn a US flag on the podium. Insane. The purpose of the Olympics is to represent your country. How crazy is that? A transgender Olympic athlete that qualified as an alternate to represent the United States at this year's Summer Olympics said last year that the goal was to win and then burn an American flag on the Olympic podium. BMX freestyle rider Chelsea Wolf wrote in a Facebook post unearthed by Fox News, "My goal is to win the Olympics so I can burn a US flag on the podium." The post, which included a link to an article on a far-left blog that was attacking the Trump administration, continued, "This is what they focus on during a pandemic, hurting trans children." Hurting trans children. They think that it's hurting them. It's hurting them to say that it's unfair for them to compete with biological women. That's how ridiculous society has become with these oppression narratives. It's ridiculous. Wolf claimed in a statement that anyone who thinks the post suggests hatred of America is sorely mistaken. Wow, coulda fooled me. Someone that wants to burn the American flag on a world stage. You're saying that we are sorely mistaken for what, making the assumption that you have hatred for America when you're burning the flag? See, this is why I discourage people from symbolism, especially radical symbolism. Flag burning is radical symbolism. Just don't do it. Just don't do it. Because don't nobody really want to hear your explanation for why you're burning a flag, to be honest. Like, people really don't care. And people, they're going to form their own beliefs as to why you're really doing it. Because that is radical symbolism. And when you engage in radical symbolism, it's very, very open to a negative interpretation. Especially for people who are very patriotic, more patriotic. And then Chelsea Wolf goes on to state that, "I'm taking a stand against fascism." So that's why I would have burned the American flag, because I'm taking a stand against fascism. I do believe that someone who is on far left blogs, someone that is on the far left, you don't have a problem with authoritarianism as long as it is pushing your agendas, what you believe in. You're totally fine with authoritarianism. You see, I'm against it from all sides. I'm against authoritarianism regardless of the side, because I believe in freedom, something that America still represents despite the disparaging of the left. But I'm Chris. What do you guys think about this whole thing? Make sure you hit the like, share, subscribe button, and blessings to you.